What do you think of this way of eating as far as how it affects heart disease, which you have, or any disease? I've been sort of preaching this for a while to you.
Oh, I know you have.
I know. And
I'm listening.
But little by little, I noticed you're picking it up. And mm-hmm. like, for example, this is what we're eating for breakfast today. Mm-hmm. And it's a big bowl of fruit, mm-hmm. which is normally, right. you don't eat this much fruit.
No,
this is my bowl.
I can't eat that much. Not the juice and then that and maybe a little cereal. And.
But I love it that you're willing yeah. to drink the juice and yeah. eat the fruit and, you know. Yeah. And the other thing is Mary and I brought this book, this Eat to Live by Dr. Joel Fuhrman. Mm-hmm. And we're sharing this. And so tell me what you've been picking up from this book.
Well, the thing with that is he has a lot of good stuff in there. He tells you about all the foods, how they affect you. Mm-hmm. I haven't read it through the whole thing because it's your book and you're taking it home with you when you leave. But I did get to the part where it talks about the food and eating a lot of raw vegetables and fruits and having a big salad, mm-hmm. having that first before you eat whatever you're going to eat, you know, after that, which is good. And I have to read more of it because mm-hmm. I really didn't get into it. But it's very interesting and I want to get the book so that I have it yeah. to refer back to.
Good. So we'll get you the book.
Okay.
So do you think...
Okay, you can buy that for me.
I'll buy you the book.
Good.
$9 on Amazon. So do you think that these things that you've read in the book are easy for you to incorporate into your lifestyle?
Yeah.
And what about Dad?
Well...
Less so, right?
The thing with him is if I make the food and he's got the mindset, he's got to change his mind. He's got to twist that around and get onto the veggies. Now, you've given him juice, which yeah. he said he liked.
He did like it. We did a carrot apple carrot apple with a little bit of raspberry in it, and he liked that.
Now, the thing is, when we have dinner tonight, I don't know what he's going to eat, you know, because I always ask him, what would you like to eat? Because I don't want to take the meat away from him right, you know, now.
Right away, yeah.
But I'm trying to throw more vegetables at him.
Right.
Which he's not a big vegetable eater. There are so many things that he doesn't like, and everybody says to me, how do you put up with him all these years? Well, you get used to it, and you just cook what he likes, and I cook what I like
yeah.
for me.
Yeah.
So, but I'm trying to make more now for him.
So do you think it has something to do with the fact that maybe he is addicted to sugar? My dad likes sweets a lot, and he likes meat. And those are two things that have been scientifically proven, mm-hmm. that your body becomes addicted to those mm-hmm. things. So it's possible that if he could wean himself off it, maybe he would like the vegetables a little more.
It's going to be a hard haul for him to do that because he's so used to doing things one way, you know, that way.
And right.
For him to change, I mean, he it's very difficult for him to change, mm-hmm. although he'll tell you it isn't. Because he's gone through a lot over the years,
right.
and he has changed. He's a funnier person. He's a lot different. But with the eating, I think it's more habit.
Yeah.
And he doesn't think.
Do you think
he's not thinking about not eating it?
Well, do you think maybe he feels like he's? Well, we'll ask Dad.
We'll have to ask him when
he comes home, but.
Yeah.
Do you think it's about him maybe feeling deprived if he can't have certain things?
I don't know if it's about being deprived.
He just likes what he likes.
He just likes what he yeah. likes, and that's what he wants to eat, and he feels he's retired, and this is the end of his life.
Oh, God.
That's how he thinks.
He's only 76.
He doesn't want to be here till 90, and I keep telling him, why not?
Why not?
Because if you can eat a good life, eat good food, mm-hmm. and live a longer life, and be here for our grandchildren, and our children, and be here a longer, you know, and be the way we are now,
and feel healthy,
very yeah. active and healthy. Why not?
Yeah.
I know people. I mean, I've heard of people. I've read of people who lived till they were 100 and. I mean, I've seen them on television, where they're still working. They're still gardening. They're still doing things. And that's great. I think that's great. Mm-hmm. I mean, aside from some of the little problems that I have, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. I mean, I can deal with that, but that might eventually disappear yeah. once I get all of this together.
Right.
So.
Well, know. I want you to live to be 100, Mom.
Oh, I want to live as long as I can. I want to be it to be with you.
Well, we're gonna keep learning about yeah. how to do more.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Love you, Mom.
I love you, sweetie.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. Bye.
Bye.